Good morning everyone. Today our topic is muscle sequelae, and before learning about the muscle sequelae, we have to learn about the different important terminologies like the agonist muscle movement, the antagonist muscle movement, and synergist muscle movement. So first of all, we will learn about the agonist muscles. For example, if we consider our medial rectus muscle as our primary muscle, and you know that the function of the medial rectus muscle is to keep the eye towards the nose. And please remember that the agonist muscle is the primary moving muscle, is called the agonist muscle, right? So if we consider our medial rectus muscles as our primary muscle, and you know that the function of the medial rectus muscle is to keep the eye towards the nose. If this is your beautiful nose, so the function of the medial rectus would be moving the eye in the medial direction towards the nose. So this is our primary muscles, which is medial rectus. And this movement of the medial rectus would be agonist movement, right? And this muscle would be agonist, right? The primary moving muscle is called the agonist muscles. Now we will discuss about the antagonist muscle movement, right? The antagonist muscle movement is the movement of our muscles against or opposite to the agonist muscles, right? We have agonist muscle, which is medial rectus. Now we have to find our muscles which will move against or which will move opposite to the medial rectus. And you know that a muscle is there which will move against or opposite to the medial rectus, and that is called, yes, the lateral rectus. If our primary muscles, which is agonist, is moving towards the nose, its antagonist muscles, which is lateral rectus, will move towards the opposite to the agonist muscles, right? So this is called antagonist muscle movement. Now we will discuss about the synergist muscle, which move the eyeball in the same direction. For example, this is our right and this is our left eye, and this is right direction, and this one is left direction, right? So you know very well that the medial rectus of the right eye, I'm talking about the medial rectus which keep the eye towards the nose. So the function of the medial rectus is to keep the eye towards the medial side, towards the nose. So medial rectus of the right eye will move the eyeball towards the left side, this direction, towards the left side. And now we are talking about the left eye, the lateral rectus of the left eye, the lateral rectus of the left eye will keep the eye, will move the eyeball towards the left side in the same direction. So we can say that the medial rectus of the right eye and the lateral rectus of the left eye, both of these muscles will move the eyeball towards the left side, towards the same direction, because this medial rectus is moving towards the left side and this lateral rectus is moving towards the left side. Both of them are moving towards the same direction. So both of them are called synergist muscles. We will take another example of the synergist muscle now. So in this example of the synergist muscles or the yoke muscles as well, the synergist muscles, the contralateral synergist muscles are also called the yoke muscles. Right. So in this example, suppose our right eye is medial rectus, sorry, lateral rectus. We are considering our lateral rectus of the right eye. The lateral rectus of the right eye will keep the eye, will move the eye towards the right side. This is right side, right? And that one is left side. And the medial rectus of the left eye will move the eye in the same direction towards the right side. So both of them are moving towards the same direction. Then these muscles are called synergist muscles or yoke muscles as well, because they are contralateral, because they are in opposite eye, they are in each eye. So that these muscles would be the synergist muscles or the contralateral synergist. and the yoke muscles as well. Hope you people are understand. In the very next video, we will discuss about the two most important laws, which is called the Herring's law and Sherrington's law.